I want to talk about viruses. Like, what is a virus? It's a very mysterious thing for a lot of people. But viruses, you can't kill them because they're really not alive in the first place. They're a piece of genetic material wrapped in a little bit of a shell. And they're very, very tiny compared to bacteria. If a virus was a ping pong ball, a bacteria would be the size of the Empire State Building. So they're very, very tiny. Some viruses are so small, you can drop them through a porcelain dish, through the little holes that they have. So viruses basically are an inactive creature that actually kind of, it's like a parasite in a way, but because it takes something from you, but it doesn't give you anything back. At least the bacteria helps you in some ways, but viruses just take, but they don't give back. So once your cells are susceptible to the virus, then they can start to invade your own cell machinery and start to switch on the duplicator. So basically that's how viruses reproduce, off your own energy from your own cells. They kind of lock in there, very similar to computer viruses. So what happens is that if you notice you have shingles pain, that's like pain down a nerve root on your back, or you have herpes virus, or you have some venereal virus type thing, or mono, that's Epstein-Barr virus. These viruses are nearly always triggered by a stress event, which is fascinating, because when you ever ask someone, when did you first start getting that thing? It was after some stress event. And that's why stress is one of the big activators, because it activates the virus, it comes out of remission, and then the cascade effect that you start going through this whole cycle. It could be like a 10-day cycle, maybe 2 weeks, before you can get over this viral infection, because antibiotics do not fix viruses. Also, you can have certain malnutrition deficiencies that can lead to more viral overloads as well. If you're eating a lot of sugar and junk foods, you don't have the proper nutrition, that can do it. But the main thing that will set you up for a viral infection is low calcium. Calcium will protect you if you have enough calcium. So if you have a virus, let's say it's a herpes virus or a cold sore or shingles, what I'm going to recommend is taking calcium. Take a calcium citrate and add it with omega-3 fatty acid. And it doesn't matter if you get omega-3 from flax oil or cod liver oil or fish oil. You want a good omega-3 with the calcium and trace minerals all together. And that many times will speed up the healing, or they put the virus back in remission. And I like to give this to like even kids that get fevers from a virus, because you can actually get them over it very fast. So that's the summary of what a virus is, and that's why you can't kill it, because it's not alive in the first place. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Please click the share button below, and I will see you in the next video.